So, it's your favorite day, it's my favorite day, it's Kazhirai's favorite day, it's podcast.
Sony's favorite day.
It's also in general. It's Podcast Monday, woo! So, topics of the day, we're gonna go over the Shift Special Edition quick, followed by YCS Origins, and some WCQ news. But first, let me get to the window. We actually have a new manga date. So, Yu-Gi-Oh! Zexal Volume 9. Pre-order now for $10. Comes out September 6, 2016. Now, what this means is promo card is going to be Ga-Ga-Ga-Ga-Head. Wait, Ga-Ga-Ga-Head. There. It's a level 6, 21 attack, 2000 defense. Effects reads, if your opponent controls a monster and you control no monsters, you can normal summon this card without tributing as a level 4 monster. When this card is normal summoned, you can target up to 2 Ga-Ga-Ga monsters in your grave, except head. Special summon them, also you cannot special summon monsters for the rest of this turn, except XYZ monsters that uses only Ga-Ga monsters as a material. XYZ monster that summoned using this as a material gains the effect, you draw one card.
Nah. Not relevant like Lightning was.
Still a promo card. That's the date. If you're interested though, playing Ga-Ga-Ga, comes out September 9th, 6th. So look out for it.
If it didn't have the restriction for you can't special summon monsters for the rest of the turn except by an Xyz summon, then it would have been a lot better. Like, I don't think it needed that restriction.
All the Ga-Ga-Ga stuff, dude.
Alright, let's go to the next topic.
In other news, Shiv Special Edition comes out this Friday. Quick reminder of what comes in here. But first, give me a second. Me. Saga Blue! No, I'm not gonna read this. Let me just go up to the page for the end. Shiv, here we are. My computer's acting weird, not now, please. Okay, here we go. So, Special Edition comes with two of either of these four cards. Am I saying that right? So, either Ebon Illusion Magician or Elements of Hero Core. Ebon Magician, the Shonen Jump effect reads, you can also XYZ summon this monster by using a rank 6 spellcaster type XYZ monster. That's really not relevant because it's used in Dark Magicians. Once per turn, you could detach one XYZ material from this card. Special summon one spellcaster type normal monster from your hand or deck. When a spellcaster normal type monster declares an attack, you can target one card your opponent controls and banish it. Again, this is for the blue. Dark Magician deck coming roughly, I want to say October. Also, we have Elemental Hero Core. I believe also another Shonen Jump promo. Requires 3 Elemental Heroes. Must be fusion summoned and cannot be special summoned by other ways. Once per turn, when this card is targeted for an attack, you can double this card's attack until the end of the damage step. At the end of the battle phase, if this card attacked or was attacked, you can target one monster on the field and destroy that monster. When this card is destroyed either by battle or card effect, you can special summon. You can target one level 8 or lower elemental hero fusion monster in your grave. Special summon that monster, ignoring its summoning conditions. And for imports, we have Magician's Robe. Effect reads, during your opponent's turn, you can discard one spell slash trap card. Special summon one Dark Magician from your deck. This is a quick effect. During your opponent's turn, if you activate a spell or trap card or effect while this card's in the grave, except during damage step, you can special summon this card, but banish it when it leaves the field. And Scare Ghost. It's a flip monster, it's also a tuner, level 1. You can special summon any number of Black Sheep tokens, zombie type, dark level 1, attack 0/0. The only card that really matters in my opinion is the Ebon Illusion Magician, because outside of Shonen Jump, this is the only way you can get it. Anybody else aside, thoughts? John?
No. I have no idea what the magicians do, Dark Magicians. I know they're broken. I know that one card where something happens, you can special summon it. That's all I know. So I have no idea what the rest of the deck does and how synergize.
John? Oh, he's not here right now. So that's it for...
I didn't really need to tell us he's not here.
That's it for Special Edition. Moving on.
This is not playable if you're in Europe, right?
Not until this Friday when it's released.
Are you sure? Because then I remember one time something was illegal for us, but was illegal for them. Because they didn't get the Special Edition.
What?
Like, some cards were... In the Special Edition, you know how we get new cards, right? Like this? Like, in Europe, they didn't get it, so it wasn't legal for them.
I remember talking about... I can't remember what card it was, though.
I think it was Wavering Ice or something like that.
Yeah, they couldn't play it till it actually came out.
Yeah, actually came out, yeah. Dude, so are these legal for Europe?
They don't have the Shonen Jump where they give you the cards. Because this is from the magazine. So,
okay.
You can't play this one.
So you can't play them in Europe, okay.
Until now. Moving on, YCS Origins this weekend. I believe this is your last YCS for this tournament season. And it could be your last chance to qualify for Nats.
It is. Wait, is it? Let me check. Go ahead, continue.
They have a crazy new side event called Generation Duels. So basically, Generation Duels is... It's a mini tournament where you get to play under one of these ban lists. The original Yu-Gi-Oh! One, the GX era, 5D's era, Zexal, or ARG V. I believe it's just, you can't mix and match, so if you're playing in a GX ban list, you only play against GX ban list. But these ban lists are nuts.
Can you play future cards?
Some of them actually you can.
So you can play like... I don't know, Klee and... Yuki, regular Yu-Gi-Oh?
In general, you can't play Pendulum Monsters.
Okay.
The original Yu-Gi-Oh! Era is the only list I've seen that says all other effects monsters are forbidden. So you can only play on the list, but everything else looks fine.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it will generally say near the bottom that all this card is forbidden or all of these are forbidden. Like GX, all the Pendulum Monsters are forbidden, all Ritual Monsters are forbidden, etc.
Oh. Synchros are forbidden too in GX?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, and you're right, Blue. This weekend is the last time chance to get the invite because the last regionals was yesterday.
Oh, God. Someone pointed out to me the other day that Shadals are pretty much banned from all these formats because all fusion monsters are banned. But you can play Teller Knights in like Zexal era, and that's pretty nutty.
Zexal is XYZ, right?
Yeah.
Oh, so that's normal. Yeah, of course you can play it in Teller Knights in Zexal format. That's when it came out, you know?
So how this will work is pretty much you get a number of rounds of Swiss. 5 to 8 duelists equals 3 rounds of Swiss. Kind of like mini locals. Only top 4 will get the mat, and you will get your respective generation. So if you play the GX generation, you get the GX max mat.
Do you know what time is the event starting?
They have it on the website.
Is it all day kind of event, or is it like it's like flights where one of the
several times throughout people... the day?
Oh, so it's flights then.
Yeah, I'll pull up quick. I remember seeing it.
I think, it's a great idea, but it's gonna be very hard to get people to join, because not only is this event exclusive, like you need to buy a ticket to get in, like to get people that had, because pretty much you have, 5 different formats, right? So 8 times 5, 40 people. So you need 40 unique players for all the flights to fly.
So, okay, I'm forgetting that. Origin starts on Wednesday because there's a game expo.
Oh, okay, then, yeah, maybe.
Let's see, where's the first one starts? Generation. Starts Thursday, that's the first one. It's $12. There's one on Friday.
Wait. Saturday. Is it 10 to 4, right? Is that the right one? Am I looking the right one?
Which one are you looking at?
10 o'clock to 4 o'clock? What time? You're moving too fast.
Sorry, I was looking at which one they had. Wednesday, they don't have any. The first one would be starting from 2 o'clock.
2 o'clock? And is there a range, or is it just 2 o'clock?
No, just 2 o'clock straight.
Okay, so then they're not doing a flight. They're just doing how many people enter is when it'll fly.
Yeah.
So you need at least 40 unique players to fly all 5 flights, or all 5 tournaments.
Looks like they're doing it roughly 3 times during the whole week.
Yeah, so I think these mats are going to be very, very exclusive. Because not only is not a lot of people going, it's going to be who's going to play this event, you know?
Yeah, it's also hard. Do they have the decks or not?
Like, yeah, exactly. That's another thing.
And Simo just tweeted at me saying, hashtag Xbox Master Race.
What?
We can't be friends anymore.
Oh, because you said Sony?
Yeah, I'm a Sony boy.
I'm a Sony boy. PC Master Race.
No, he said Xbox.
Yeah, PC. I'm saying PC Master Race.
Yeah, of course PCs, but you got a backup.
Oh, backup? It's going to be Nintendo, obviously.
John, can you help me out here?
He's gone again.
John, everybody. In addition, you get 3 booster packs, but I'm pretty sure it's most likely going to be shift packs, so we'll see how that works out.
Actually, the last regional flights I've been doing, it's never like the newest set. It's always like 6 sets ago or something like that.
Whatever you have left over.
I got Primal Origins for Las Vegas regional flight. I was like, what the hell is this, dude? What can I pull this thing?
Whatever they have available.
It's really bad. There's stuff that's like, I reprinted the tin already, you know? Like, come on, dude. Junk packs.
So, we'll see how that works. Again, good luck to everybody going to Origins. We're not going.
Yeah, I'm not going.
I'm not going, dude. I'm broke.
Tickets too expensive.
Next topic, we can do this first. Then we'll talk about our sponsors. So, WCQ News in Japan, they're getting some sick stuff. If you qualify, you get these 6 leaves. Ooh.
Ooh.
And this sick mat with Blue Eyes and Dark Magician, which I really want now.
This is their nationals or their WCQ?
Yeah, this is for their WCQ.
Those sleeves look like all the other sleeves they have.
But the mat, that's the main thing.
What monsters are they?
Blue Eyes and Dark Magician.
Oh, there's different alternate art?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I feel like, I don't know, I've been seeing a lot of cool mats lately, and this one's kind of lazy.
But I like Blue Eyes.
This reminds me of the 2014 mat, where it's just like 2 cards, and then you put a border in the middle.
Oh, God. I remember that one now.
So bad. At least they made the image stretch all the way to the edge of the map, the mat, not like 2014 mat, where it wasn't.
Let's not talk speak about that mat.
It's like the most horrible mat ever.
Let's talk about our sponsors quick, then we actually get through deck lists.
Okay. So sponsors, check us out on Amazon,
TCG Player,
eBay. At Project YGO, it's Project YGO TCG on Amazon. Follow us on Facebook, follow us on YouTube, and shoutouts to Ultra Pro, best sleeves in the game, Ultimate Guard, best deck box in the game, and Aloe Vera, best thirst quencher.
Best liquid
in the game. It's a food, it has aloe in it, so like you won't get hungry.
I'm pretty sure you're missing one.
Am I? I don't remember.
Costco.
Oh, they're still sponsoring us? Damn, dude. It's got a troopers.
I think they would fire Dennis by now.
I know, right?
Slogan for like millions of times.
So in terms of, WCQ time, some pretty interesting WCQs happened over this weekend. First, the main one we have is Central America, we'll talk about in a bit, but first we have Oceanic. Now Oceanic was really special in regards that Australian Nationals were 2 days beforehand, so they have to play it out they have to play 3 days straight pretty much if you're from Australia.
Oh, is that what happened?
It looked like.
Saturday, Sunday, and then Monday was Oceanic?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay, that makes sense then. Alright then, it's okay that's Monday.
It's still weird. I mean,
it's
like,
still weird, but it's okay. It makes
sense. It's also like putting people from Australia into overdrive, man. Like, well, where else does Oceanic affect? Other than New Zealand.
New Zealand and Australia. I think it's really smart because you just have all the players already there, you know, for another day. You don't have to do two trips. Yeah, does Australia Nationals, was it combined? Did Australia have a Nationals and then New Zealand had a Nationals?
New Zealand had it, I believe, either a month ago or 2 weeks ago.
Okay, and so they would have to, they would flow in like Saturday or something like that, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
In terms of the placing, I found this from a YouTube channel called Eternal Dragon of Chaos, like OZ, like Aussie.
Okay.
Oh, you're right, boy. Netherlands. Oh, I just pulled it up. Sorry, hold on. New Zealand was on April 24th, and then Australia was yesterday and Saturday, 11th and 12th.
Actually, no, I checked this morning. Not.
Yeah. And only thing that only you get for going first in Australia Nationals is that you get VIP for the Oceanic one. First place gets the YCS prize card, and travel accommodations to Continentals, which is same place. What a bunch of bullshit.
We'll pay for a last day for your hotel.
What a bunch of bullshit. What the hell? Wow, that's funny.
In terms of the top four, fourth place was Kalum Scott playing XYZ Monarchs. Third place was Isaac Scott playing Demise Cosmo. Second place, the name's a bit familiar. Dennis, do you know who this guy is?
I'm not looking at what you're looking at.
John,
Second place?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Bowden. I remember that.
So yeah, Bowden, pretty good Yu-Gi-Oh player.
You want ARG Anaheim?
Yeah. Yes. Anaheim. One of the Oceania's finest. He was playing PK Fire, got second place. Let's go through the deck really quick. Two Sirs, one Cowcab, one Liebig, triple Terror Top, one Aelich, double Farfar, one Calgraf, one Tour Guide, one Gloves, triple Skarm, double Cloak, one Tucka Tomboard, triple Boots, one Rubik, triple Maxi, and triple Effect Veiler. For the spells, double Allure, one Rengeki, a Foolish, and triple Twin Twister. For the traps, Vanities, and triple Fogblade. Side deck, triple Vanities, double Flying Sea, triple System Down, double Full House, double Master Restrict, and triple Anti-Spell. For the extra deck, Super Dante, Virgil, double Beatrice, Corbidge, Dark Rebellion XYZ Dragon, Nightmare Shark, double Breaksword, double Giga, one Giga Brilliant, one Levier, triple Dante, and F-Zero. I got this deck list from Glasgow Yu-Gi-Oh! Shoutouts to him. Great videos there. So, then you're the resident BA player. What do you think about this?
I'm not a pro PK Fire BA player, but like I don't like it because of the PK engine. I feel like it just really clogs up the BA engine, but if you look at this list, he really minimizes the PK engine. So he's really running a 6-card engine, I believe. No, wait, no.
7.
9-card. 9-card engine.
Or 9-card, yeah, 9-card.
Yeah, 3, 2, 1, and then 3. That's math, right? 9, yeah, 9. So usually people run like 3, 2, 2, or 3, 3, 2, or something like that. So that's that increases more PKs. So the more PKs you have, the more bricky your hands can be. Because like, you can draw like a PK, PK, and then like BA, BA. And it's like, it's really bad, you know? Or if you draw the trap card, it's really bad as well. So generally, you don't want to draw the trap card, and you just want to get it with
search
like...
Search it, yeah.
Yeah, search it. You pretty much want to search it. And I feel with the minimal PK engine, you can just search... You can mill it and hopefully hit it and search a Fiendish Chain. Which I think that's why... That's like the only reason why this is better than Pure, because of the Fiendish Chain card. Like, getting Fiendish Chain is so important now, because like I would like to say that Monarch is probably your worst matchup, and getting like Big Black Guide or like Stormforth... Big white guy, it kind of really hurts. So you know, the Fiendish Chain is broken. You have to play around the Fiendish Chain. Other than that, I mean, it's pretty standard. He's still playing the triple maxi, which I think right now it's kind of bad because of the monarchs. Like, monarchs are everywhere, so those are easy side outs. But it's also a really dead card in the main deck. And Allure Darkness to dig into your cards, like what Calvin Tahan said, like, you play your hand and then you Allure Darkness in the end, and hopefully you'll draw a Maxi or a Veiler. Or a Vanity's Emptiness. That's also very interesting. He's running the Vanity's Emptiness. It's not very good against Monarchs, like I said again. But maybe like in Australia, I think Fire King Cosmos is very popular. Or Cosmos in general is very popular in Australia. In America, it's not. So I wouldn't be playing Vanity's if I was in America meta. But what's your thoughts, John?
I mean, I'm not too familiar with PK Fire, so having that many monsters always seems like you have monsters to block for you, but on the trap end, it's like seems really minimal, and I don't know, like you're relying on monsters to do your work for you when your monsters aren't extremely strong. I always felt that it was like a weird pitch for BA. Like you'd want to spam an OTK in like in the very beginning. You wanted to like spam an OTK when we got like the Virgils and stuff, but now it's like we already got two hits on the main monsters, Sir and Graf. So like I'm not even sure if we should be playing a monster full build, but I don't know. I never really agreed with PK Fire, like to be honest.
And also, he's only running two Beatrices in instead he's running the Giga Brilliant Butterfly build. I don't know. I haven't tested that card too much, and like BA isn't very prominent. Like I said before, like it's a lot of Monarchs, so that card isn't that great. But yeah, it's all right. On his side, he's running a triple system down. Yeah, I don't feel like you need that card against Cosmo. Like, Cosmo is probably like my easiest matchup right now, just because they burn so much, and then you can like bar Nightmare Shark for game. So I don't know. That's my opinion. Like, maybe Pierre's different from PK. I haven't played PK. I haven't tested PK. So
I think PK would lose out against Cosmo because they don't have as many traps to defend themselves with, and then. Yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Because like, if you look at all his main deck, nothing stops what Cosmo can actually do.
Yeah, yeah. So. He's not running like breakthrough skill and stuff.
Yeah, he's running a very minimalistic.
Yeah, actually,
engine.
Yeah. PK Fire is actually. Yeah, you're right. It is very weak against Cosmo because the Fiendish Chain is like really dead because you can't really Fiendish Chain.
Can't even target.
Yeah. First of all, you can't target, and then they say you hit him with Slack Kick. They just tag out. So
they're
like,
just gonna tag out for a bigger monster.
Well, the point of Slogblade is you can target your monsters and then they can attack to it.
Yeah, they that's like you use the trap card to defend yourself. That's why you're using it. But like, it's like uphill battle, I think, in my opinion.
That's why he needs the system downs.
Yeah, I agree with that. Then
for it's definitely different because like you're running plenty more traps to stop the plays.
That's all I have to say, Bui.
Okay. So, congrats to him, second place. But that's not first, is it? John, tell me who got first place.
Second place still gets...
they got invited.
No, second place and first place still get the flight to Orlando, Florida to play Worlds in America.
Yeah.
So, first place was Matthew Cassiero with Xyz Monarchs.
Monarchs, everybody.
Yeah.
Bui's favorite deck right now.
Brick City.
I don't want to talk about it, dude. I've bricked so many times. Is it Orlando?
Yeah, it's Orlando, Florida. Is it Orlando? No, maybe it might be in Orlando.
Wherever Disney World's at.
Yeah, it's Orlando.
That's Orlando, Florida.
So, going to Central America, though. So, Central America... So, okay, quick funny story. So, over the weekend, we learned that Mexico is considered Central America.
Well, for Konami standards, it's not...
For Konami standards.
Yeah, Konami just lumped Mexico into Central America for no real reason. It's technically a North American state, but
yeah. Maybe the Japanese are just ignorant.
Possibly.
So
go ahead, Bui.
Central America World Championship Qualifier at Hotel Mission Carlton, Guadalajara, Mexico.
Guadalajara.
571 duelists in the main event, 19 dragon duelists. In terms of... Well, let's go to a dragon duelist first. So, second place, we have... John, can you read it? Because you're blocking the thing.
Daniel Isai Coronel Contreras.
Playing Cosmos, but that's not first place, is it?
Yeah, first place is Ronaldo Isai Sierra Cabello.
He playing Domain Monarchs, and someone actually did a deck profile for it. So, let me put this up quick.
These dragon duelist kids are, like, savage, dude.
Dude... They have all these good decks.
I bet you, like, they just trash all the other dragon duelists that come in with, like,
no
starter decks.
Was dragon duelist, was it not, what's it called? Sealed?
I don't think this is sealed. Draft? This is WCQ.
Oh, okay then.
But in terms of, either way, I was going to say, John, remember the last YCS, the scrap player won against BA?
Yeah, I was like, what?
Fundamentals, everybody.
That kid was amazing.
So, this guy's deck, he has triple Aether, triple Erebus, triple Idea, double Idols, double Red Lair, double Maxi, one Karaz, one Majesty's Fiend, one Bandy's Fiend, triple Pantheism, triple Domain, triple Tenacity, triple Return, triple Stormforth, one March of the Monarchs, one Foolish, one for one, two Scoldings, and two Primes. For the side deck, he had one Fog King, two DD Crows for the Mirror Match, two Effect Veilers, one Majesty's Fiend, two Trap Eaters, double Twin Twister, double System Down, double Chalice, Regeki. For the extra deck, he had this card, he had nothing.
It was Domain Monarchs.
This YouTube channel was Raguel Ortiz. Shouts to him for actually recording it.
Right, next part.
I was gonna say anything about the deck, but it's pretty standard.
Standard.
What, the exception of Trap Eater, most likely for the clean matchup.
Also gets rid of the
Master Strict.
Yeah. Master Strict, so it's nice.
And also, that gives you a free fodder.
Free fodder, yeah.
Congrats to him. They showed the prizes on the website. I'll show you guys quick. These prizes were actually pretty sick this year. So, these trophies are totally lit, literally. That's the title.
I don't even understand.
It's naming, man. Who's in charge of the naming?
So, each trophy has a different color determining on what place you get. So from 8th through 5th place, you get these yellow trophies in the back. From 4th to 3rd, you get these green trophies. 2nd place, you get this blue trophy. And 1st place is this slightly bigger red trophy.
You said 4th to 8th gets yellow?
Oh, 5th. 8th, wait.
5th to 8th, okay. So 3rd and 4th gets green?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who gets to go to Worlds?
1st and 2nd, I believe.
Is it 1st and 2nd or just 1st?
I don't... They get like, oh no, they got 4 people, I think.
They get 4? Good, we can confirm. Can you confirm or?
I don't remember.
Okay, I'll look it up. Go ahead, okay. Continue.
I was gonna say, those trophies actually look pretty nice, but I don't know why they went with that title for. Like, what does it mean they're totally lit? Like, what?
They're lit up, dude.
The bottom, the base has lights in them. Okay.
Yeah.
I didn't see that. I was like, are they making I was confused too.
They get 6 trophies in addition to the other prizes. In addition, Winamat, this event was the... Is it Yuto? John, can you help me out?
Let me see.
There's too many. Is there Yuya? There's Yuto. There's like two
other. Is it
other
the XC's one?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Yuto.
With Dark Rebellion mat, looks pretty sick. Was last year's the Yuya mat?
For...
The All Eyes Rebellion, just the Winamat in general?
Oh, no, it was Clearwing, no?
No, which is the one that David won for Nats?
I don't know, I have one too. Let me pull it up.
I'm pretty sure the Odd Eyes with Yuya, because I bought it from him.
Oh, did you?
Pretty sick.
I don't recall.
Pretty sick mat for a Winamat. This most likely will make an appearance US Nationals, so I'm going to win it instead of Nats.
You only gotta win 3 in a row, I think. Yeah, it is. It's Odd Eyes with the Odd Eyes guy.
Yuya? He's the main protagonist, man!
I forgot their name. So this year it's gonna be the XYZ guy?
Yeah.
XYZ.
Studo.
Yeah. They're not the same character, are they? They're.
This point, they are. It's
complicated. Oh, yeah, that's right.
So the same character?
We'll spoil it for you, because basically, Yuto kinda dies. But
no.
Last second, he
like his soul in Yuya.
Yeah,
it's like some Yami Yogi stuff. Yuya.
No, but is he the different dimension version of Yuya?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's the Xyz version of Yuya.
Okay, that's all. I was asking. I was wondering if he was Kaiba or if he was the different dimension.
Like Kaiba is Reiji.
He doesn't even duel, dude.
Kaiba is a DDD guy, right?
Yeah.
But he doesn't even duel. Like Boo says, he doesn't even duel.
It's so disappointing, dude. They build him up and then all this stuff happens.
Yeah, they'd start hopping dimensions and then like they forget about him.
Oh, they left him back? Back no, home?
He's supposed to be the leader of it too.
Yeah.
They left him back.
They left him back.
No airtime.
It's pretty dumb, dude. In terms of the meta, it's pretty diverse. We have 171 monarchs. But breaking that down, that's 93 XYZ is 78 domain. 153 cosmos. Like I said in the Project Yu-Gi-Oh! Facebook page, 103 perform pals, which I was surprised to be at number 3. Number 4 is Burning Abyss / Phantom Knights, 72.
Yeah, I would have expected Burning Knights to be over perform pals.
They found out how not to break.
Apparently.
19 cleaves, a lot more than usual. 15 mermails, 8 anti-metas, 6 Yosenjus, 6 Magispectors, 5 Kaijus, 5 Psyframes, 4 Fluffles, 3 Heroes. Before I continue, Konami went nuts. They usually put these other ones in categories, but they actually put the numbers down.
Oh, instead of others?
Yeah, so 3 yeah. Deskbots, 2 Tellers, 2 Infernoids, 2 Counter Fairies, 2 Sidras, 2 Speedroids, 1 Madoche, 1 Ignites, wow. 1 Chaos Dragon, 1 Volcanics, 1 Necroz, 1 Dennis' favorite deck, 1 Grave Keeper, and 1 Blue Eyes.
They can't come back from the grave? Because, like, and this went to Central America? That 1 Madolche, dude.
And by Dennis' favorite deck, I mean 1 Blackwing.
Oh, Blackwing? I thought Spellbooks.
Okay,
so. So, to go back to what we're saying, only first place gets to go to Worlds.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so all of the trophies are just for trophies.
Just, all I remember is US gets 6.
Yeah, US gets 6, and then apparently Australia gets 2, Japan gets 4, they get 2 from west side, 2 from east side, everywhere else gets 1, I believe.
In terms of top 16, a bit diverse, but not as much as what we saw earlier. We had 5 Monarchs, and they divide up as 3 Brilliant Fusion and 2 Extra Deck. That's kind of unusual, we haven't seen this in the past.
2 Brilliant and 2 Extra Deck?
No, 3. That's how they divided it up.
Oh, so probably it was the Quick Draw version, huh?
No, actually, from what I've seen, the Brilliant stuff doesn't have the Quick Draw engine. Because you know how some XYZ version, they run Instant Fusion instead?
Yeah.
I think that's what qualifies.
No, you're saying that they split it up 5, right? 3 Extra yeah. and 2...
No, 3 Brilliant, 2 Extra.
Yeah, so I'm saying the 2 is probably... Like with
Okay. I see what you're saying now. 3 Cosmos, but 1 Demise, 1 Fire King, and 1 I put in quotes here because it just said Cosmo.
Oh, okay.
3 Burning Abyss, 2 PK Fires, and 1 Pure. 3 Performer Pals, with breakdown 2 Performer Pal, 1 Magispector, Draco, Slayer, Performer Pal.
That was a Monster Mash one, right?
No.
Oh, that was top 64, top 32.
Well, 1 Yosenju and 1 Monster Mash.
Oh, okay.
It's Kaiju, BA, Speedroids, Gallus, the Starbird. It's pretty much BA.
I don't know how Gallus works. Like, how it synergizes with the...
You mill monster. If you mill monster, you special summon, he's a 3?
Yeah. And then what?
You hope you hit Phoenix Rhino or something? I don't
know. Yeah, that's why, exactly. Like, then what, you know? Like, I think it makes sense if you're hitting PK. Because it's another, like... You can summon PK and then, you know, do something with it. But... I don't know.
Like, you can use your other 2 Terra Tops?
Oh, like, yeah, maybe. That seems really bad, though.
I don't know. Spoiler alert, he didn't make it that far afterwards. Now, 1 shocker, though. Galileo, last year's 2nd place world champion, 1st place Nash champions, did not make day 2, from what I saw. Going to round 6, he was already X3.
Yeah.
He was playing anti-meta barrier statues.
Yeah. The only game he won was the one he feature matched in.
First round.
Yeah.
That was against Cleed Demise.
I wonder what made him choose that deck. Like, you know, world champions, they don't, like, play troll decks, you know? Like, maybe he knew something that we didn't know. And
I couldn't afford the other stuff, and I tried to pick up stuff last minute. This is all I had.
Maybe he knows something that we don't, and, like, he just didn't execute correctly.
In theory, I think he was playing with basic fundamentals, knowing what the meta's gonna be.
Oh, okay.
That's my thought process, but...
Yeah, it's like Hoban. Like, Hoban makes a really good deck, but then he scrubs out with it. And then everyone's like, oh, it's pretty smart. And then they start winning with it.
Okay, in terms of top four, fourth place,
John PK Fire. Oh, Gerald Chavez.
Oh, another quick note, Konami calls PK Fire Burning Knights. That sounds 10 times sicker in my opinion.
That yeah, does like, actually sound pretty sick.
Yeah, Burning Knights.
Can you say the other places while I get the decklist right. for the other one ready?
Third place was Angel, Angel Barcenas. Second place was Ricardo Mendoza. And then first place was Brandon Aguilar Gonzalez, who we have, oh yeah, I forgot the name of the decks they were playing. Angel Barcenas was playing Burning Knights. Ricardo Mendoza was playing Fire King Cosmo, which is actually pretty surprising. And Brandon Aguilar Gonzalez was playing Brilliant Monarch, who we have the deck list for.
Shoot, I didn't put down who I got this from. All I remember was the quality wasn't as great as I hoped it for, because there's a glare for the holo card, so I couldn't tell what one of the cards were.
The video was removed, so I can't tell you.
It was removed again?
Yeah, it's removed again.
Okay, so quick background story. When I was trying to get this deck list, I had the video, but the quality was like meh, so I tried to refresh thinking it would be like better quality, but it turns out the whole video was removed. I panicked. I somehow got the video to work again to finish up the deck list.
Well.
So going over the deck quick, get 3 Aether, 2 Idols, 1 Majesty's Fiend, double Karaz, double Idea, double Idols, double Red Layer, 1 Effect Baylor, 1 Gemknight Lazuli, double Maxi, double Twin Twizzler, double Domain, double Return, double triple Pantheism, triple Return. Did I say that?
I don't know, Louis.
Triple Tenacity. This is where things get a bit iffy. On the video, he only showed 1 Stormforth, but that might only make his deck 39. So I assumed he played 3, because most Monarchs, all Monarchs play 3. 1 Instant Fusion, 1 Foolish, double Brilliant, and triple Prime. The side deck, 1 Fog King, double Ghost Reaper, 1 Vanity's Fiend, 1 Sidra, 1 Regeki, 1 Curse Seal of the Forbidden Spell, double Chaos Trap Hole, double Decree, 1... Okay, this is where I couldn't tell what the card was because of the glare. So I thought it was a Master Restrict. Double Chain Disappearance at 1 Vanity's. Extra deck, Shark Fortress, Durendo, Volcasaurus, Beatrice, M7, Gaia Dragon, 38, Hope Harbinger, Nancer Dragoon, Super Dante, Chimera Tech Fortress, Omega, Magna Liger, Dante, Sephirnite, and Pleiades. Interesting that this could be a 41 card deck if the theory is right.
So we talk about the deck a little fast?
Yeah.
I think it's very interesting that he's running 2 domains. Usually they run only one in the extra deck marks, especially. And the random 1 Veiler.
Yeah, I was like, why?
I don't know. I find it funny when people are like splashing like a Veiler or like a 1 Maxi. Like, what? Okay.
Sure. I guess.
Sure. Yeah, sure. I guess. Instant Fusion is actually pretty beast, but he's not running.
Triple.
He's not running Garnet over the Lazuli. Because if you go Garnet, you can go Instant Fusion into Garnet, Norden Garnet, and then go Abyss Dweller. And then that's what happened to me at Las Vegas Regionals.
Oh, Jesus, just, dude. That sounds horrible.
Yeah, that happened to me. He went Dweller, Shark. What was it? Shark? The Bahamas? The guy attacked me. Everyone attacked
Shark
twice,
Fortress.
And
Shark
like
Fortress.
Majesty. So, I don't know what it was, man. It was sick, though.
You blocked it out, dude.
Just the Dweller itself was like, all right, I can't win, you know? Now I got hope I can't die. I don't die, and I died. So yeah, there's no reason for him to run Lazuli, because he's not running Jackknight, right?
No.
Yeah, so like, he just ran Garnet, to be honest. Because Lazuli could have been a beater, at least.
Okay.
Yeah. So, I think Boo was telling us about a misplay this guy made. Like, he makes Volcasaurus, right? And then he pops a monster, and then attacks the monster without overlaying into
Gaia.
Another monster without overlaying into Gaia, and that would have done like a lot more damage.
Because Gaia pierces.
Attacking. Yeah, because Gaia pierces. So I was like, why? And then he main phase 2, He overlays the guy on top of the Bulkasaur. So yeah. I was like, what?
I said that. I was like, oh, I told in our chat, it's like, oh, he didn't overlay Gaia. And then Anthony was like, oh, maybe he couldn't afford it. I'm like, he did it in Mayface 2, though. He's like, whoa, okay, no excuse there. Yeah.
Interesting note, you see the Omega and Ghost Reaper, assuming it's late game, but most likely, I don't think it works out.
I don't even know why he decided 2. Like, you're supposed to run 3 if you're gonna side that. Ghost Reaper?
Oh.
Like, what's the point of just running 2, if you ask me?
His side looks very, like, I don't know what he's trying to do, you know? He has, like, the 2 Ghost Reapers, the 1 Cyber Dragon.
He has the chain disappearance.
For the mirror match.
Is that a thing?
Okay, when a monster with 1,000 or less attack points summoned, banish that monster with 1,000 or less attack, then your opponent banishes all monsters with the same name as that card from their hand and deck.
Oh, so you do the same thing with BA back then, where you summon your own and then you chain your disappearance it?
Yeah. He's a dick if he does that.
That's pretty cool. Alright, that's fine. Well, the other weird thing is like the one Vanities, the one Cyber Dragon, the one Curse Seal,
He has the Cyber Dragon because he has the Fortress and the extra.
Yeah, but like just one?
But just like, one. So I'm like, why even? Why run Curse Seal as well? Like, that card's not even that good.
Yeah, I would rather have that Star Dragon be a system down, change the Chimeratech and the extra to Norden, change the Lazuli to Garnet. And...
Honestly, I don't even think system down is even needed against this deck. Because they have like Stormforth. So
yeah, but I'm saying like he has a Star Dragon, so I'm trying to replace it with something. Yeah.
Yeah, and then he'd have an extra slot in his extra deck. He doesn't need Fortress Dragon.
Yeah, exactly. So the Fog King. Go ahead. Continue.
Go ahead.
Yeah, so the Fog King actually has been, I find it quite popular, because if you have Fog King plus March, but he's not playing March, like, Mirror Match, they can't get over that. Like, there's zero outs to Fog King plus March. Am I correct?
Wait, can't you Twin Twister March?
Oh, man, like, yeah. That's like a Twin Twister March, and then you still get it over Fog King.
Yeah, that's the issue, because, like...
Yeah.
You have to find a way to destroy Fog King, and like, you need literally Twin Twister Raigeki to get over Fog King.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Like I always thought Fog King was a good card against Monarch. I wasn't sure why people weren't running it, but then again, I saw like you needed like 3 monsters on the field.
Yeah, it was very flimsy. Like it would have been really weak. So I mean, Fog King plus March is like pretty OP though.
Yeah.
I'm looking at game 1, he got over a board with an Infinity, a Gaia Dragon, and a Dark Witch. That guy's nuts.
He regeki'd the board or what?
No, he
summoned the Cyber Dragon.
No, he got Erebus, Aether, a Prime, and a Red Leer.
Oh, God.
Cool.
Savage, dude.
That is a nut.
Is this first place?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. It was, the finals was...
Fire King Cosmo, and then Monarch Xyz.
Oh, Fire King Cosmo.
I feel like that deck fizzles if you get over past that board turn 1. Like, you should just scoop it up if that happens.
Yep.
That's pretty much it. Congrats to him. They actually have the video of the prize ceremony. I'm going to show you a bit of it. Assuming Facebook wants to work for me. I mean, it works.
Also, it was ARG St. Louis's weekend, too.
Yeah, I want to go over one of the decks, because it was pretty unique.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you have it. Okay.
So, yeah, you have the award ceremony right here. It's from the Phantom Store Facebook page. Everything was in Spanish, so I couldn't understand anything. Oh, this is 10 minutes. I'm not going to wait that long.
Basically, they're awarding the cool trophies to the kids that won this.
Congrats to them.
Go to the end where he gets the trophy. The winner gets the trophy. That's all I care about.
Here's the pitcher thing.
I want to see him like put it in the air, you know?
Okay.
Kiss the trophy.
I don't know where he gets exact. I think it's around here.
A little sooner, because he's already holding it.
No, they're holding out the green ones right now.
Oh.
Okay, just because I was trying to figure out who got third and fourth.
He watched. Okay.
So. Disclaimer, I could have got third and fourth wrong. That's my bad. They didn't
I don't think it matters because they get the same trophy, right?
Yeah.
And I think the same prize can be confirmed.
Oh, no. Doesn't one of them get a Minerva?
No, same. They get the same thing. Oh. Neither of them gets Minerva. They both, the third and fourth gets complete set of Corp, Docs, Bosch, and Ship. Oh. No one gets Minerva.
Oh, here's first place. You see the shoulder. Oh, dude, he was feeling at the weight, dude.
Dang. How happy.
So, congrats to him.
Yeah.
What if they dropped it?
Oh, God!
let me reiterate. Top 16 all got the YCS Minervas, Super Minervas.
Oh, okay.
Top Cut all got Top Cut game mats. And first place gets another Minerva. So, yeah. Yep.
Just goes to show, when you get good at Yu-Gi-Oh, you get good stuff.
It'd be like top 1%.
So, last thing for them, we would call it a night. ARG happened last weekend, St. Louis. Only 110 people.
Only 110?
Yeah.
Oh my god, it's less than Vegas regionals.
So I tuned in for top 4. It was Patrick Colvin versus some guy with a Domain Monarch. I'm sorry, I don't remember your name. Game 1 took an hour and a half.
Was top 4, was it not timed?
No,
it
they don't.
They don't time?
That was the worst experience I had in my life, dude.
It was just Tobin stalling.
They're both stalling until they had an out.
Stalling is not slow playing, right? But
no, like recycling cards.
Oh, it was Monarch versus Monarch?
Yeah, Domain versus XYZ.
Almost. But then, like, Tobin's playing XYZ, right?
Yeah.
Does Top Cut not get timed at all, or just Top 4 doesn't get timed?
I saw sometimes Top 8. I don't know if they still do that.
Oh, okay. Cause I know I was watching stream right after it ended, right after round one, and then I overheard the commentator say that they both got slow play warnings.
Dude, I have breaking news.
Yeah.
SEMO is going to Nats.
Oh yeah, I know that.
The audience don't know that.
Oh, yeah, SEMO's going to Nats.
Wow, you should have told us.
Well,
wouldn't have been breaking news then.
this isn't SEMO stream. It's P stream.
But SEMO's a subdivision of Project Unity. So, yeah, Patrick Colby got second place. He lost because he forgot how anti-spell friggins worked. He ripped it and tried to play it.
Anti-spell?
No, the Twin Twister.
Oh. What was he playing against?
PK Fire.
PK Fire. Oh, anti-spell is OP.
So let's go. Actually, Holman's has the most unique build I've seen so far. Go over it quick, then see why it doesn't work. If you're playing Nats, if you're Holman. Triple Erebus, triple Ether, one Karaz, one Zaborg, the Mega Monarch. Double Quick Draw, double Red Layer, double Idea, one Eidos, one Mithra, one Garnet, triple Tenacity, triple Pantheism, triple Stormforth, triple Return, one Domain, triple Brilliant Fusion, one Foolish, one 1-for-1, one Holman, Upstart. Triple Prime and one Escalation. The side deck, one Spirit of the Harp. He put that down. Triple Effect Veiler, one Sidra, one Sidra Core, one Majesty's Fiend, one Idea, one Idols, double Mithra, triple Twin Twister, and one Chimera Tech. Extra deck, Crystal Wing, Pleiades, Volca, Durendo, Magna Liger, Adrius, Hope Harbinger, Wind Up Zemio. Gimmick Puppet, Giant Crusher, Gaia Dragons, Sephirnite, Michael, Ultimaya Token, and Double Omega. So the crazy thing I saw was he would tribute summon Zaborg, pop like either Cross or Ether, then use the effect, send the Omega, use the Mega effect, recycle, like put graveyard cards back into his deck, and all the Omega as well.
What would he put back in his deck?
Stuff he needs to recycle with.
Like what?
A Prime.
What?
Wait, was it Monk?
Can you do that with Prime?
Do that with Prime. It's fine.
I don't see the benefits of doing that play.
His back row, like he was out of Primes in the back row, like for his Spell and Trap. And he needed it. He also recycled
monsters
too.
I guess he ran out of Primes.
What's the card next to Ultimayo? To the left of it?
Michael?
Michael.
Michael, so he's not running Clearwing?
Yeah, he's running Crystal Wing.
Oh, Crystal Wing, I'm sorry. It's on the far left.
In general, like, it's always Ultimaya, Crystal Wing. The others are debatable. Either Stardust Spark, Michael. That's all I can think of.
I'm surprised he's not playing Soul Charge.
So, can you explain why he cited an extra idea in Eidos?
Proper Lemur.
Yeah, if he doesn't need Quick Draw stuff to go off.
Okay.
I don't know, man. This is Hobid.
Why is he playing that card in the
Spirit
side?
The Harp? I don't know.
I don't even know why he's decided it.
Was that a bet?
I think he's trolling.
That might have been a bet.
It might have been a bet or a troll of some sort. Like, honestly.
I couldn't fire a Dark Witch, so I just gave up with a Lily engine and just put this in the side.
I don't know.
I don't know how Oven does this, dude.
Escalation is getting quite popular in the Monarch matchup, in the Monarch builds.
Yeah, because summoning Erebus in your opponent's turn is pretty dumb.
Yeah, but I don't know. I feel like it's a win more card.
Yeah. Well, because he's playing the Quick Draw build, he can afford to do that because you can use that for Ultimate to go off. Because like you don't want to set like back row that you're gonna regret setting later.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know what else to say. Holman's just hoping.
Who was first place? Was it pretty standard?
Edo Saladins with PK Fire, it looked pretty standard. You also see he ran the Vanities with the Fogblade too.
Vanities with Fogblade, the show.
Yeah, everything else is pretty standard. OTK oriented, the one gloves, triple boots, two cloth, like you said, less PK oriented.
So this is the 9 card engine?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm guessing they're testing it out, seeing how good it does.
That side. See, this is a real side, you know? You know what you're doing. You know you're going to side in and out. This is a real side.
Like, this side's legit.
This actually looks like my side, but, you know, I'm not
the minus Sans is the system downs, right?
Yeah, I have a Magic Collector over system downs. Yeah. And I have Crush Cards over the Flying Seas.
So congrats to him, got first place. He got whatever Pride ARG does. Is it cash?
Yeah, it's cash. He like had 2,500, I think?
Might be 15.
I think it's 15.
He's like a third of the way there for a PlayStation 4 VR system.
Well, he already has it.
No, it's like 399.
Yeah, it's
1,500.
Oh! I thought you said 150.
No!
100.
Coming, like you should coming have in it. Top 64, you get 50 bucks. So,
oh, that's right, you got like 20, didn't you?
I got 50.
Oh.
I made $20 because entry is 30.
Yeah.
It's expensive.
Yeah, it's expensive.
but unlimited side events.
It's only Winamats. And it's their shitty Winamat. It's not like official Konami ones where people actually buy them.
We need them to sponsor us.
I don't want ARD to sponsor us. I don't want to be. I want to be Konami sanctioned one day.
Oh, shots.
Shots. I mean, I'm stating facts, I guess.
Yeah. So, congrats to him. He got the stuff. That's pretty much it. I believe South America's WCQ is also this weekend, so look out for that.
Wait, what's South America?
It's like Brazil, Peru.
Okay.
Everything under Panama.
Okay, that's so South America. Central America.
It's just Mexico.
Mexico to Panama.
To Panama.
And then South America is everything below Panama.
Oh, hey. I wonder if Africa gets a WCQ.
They're considered Europe, I think.
Oh, yeah? That's legit.
Then 2 weeks is Nats. Afterwards.
But how much are you practicing, Bui?
I realize Quick Draw is not working as much as I wanted to.
Okay, so Dennis.
Yes.
This is what Bui told me. Like, legit, okay. He just told me this. I realize when I don't practice, I top a vet. I mean, I get really far in the vets.
Yeah, dude. Like was it YCS Anaheim? That one region was I played Klee
like
Turbo?
Shadow.
Klee Turbo is not... It's a freaking automatic, man. You're like... It's like bragging about Chainbird.
No, but like, YCS Anaheim, when he got really far, he only
practiced
that for 2 days.
You practiced for that, didn't you?
No, remember, like, for you... Like, you all wanted to go to your house, but I just went straight home to play Pokemon?
No, but like, in general, you knew what your deck is doing. You played, like... You played.
I played like artifacts one event beforehand. That was like Card Rush. I have no idea how I do this stuff, okay? I'll figure it out when we get to Nets.
That's like one event, bro. It's like one event. What'd you lose to? The Barakis, what was he playing?
Burning Abyss.
Burning Abyss.
Told you, dude, that was the stupidest.
Like, he had the sickest play. Bui plays Shadow Fusion with two Dantes on the field, and then Barakis is like, Fire Lake, and then he sends the two Dantes, and then Bui has to summon from his hand.
Okay.
No. Yeah, and then wasted he wasted the Shadow Fusion pretty much.
That's one of them.
Yeah.
Then like the game two, it was stupid. Like he tried to Wing Blast my window. I chained Trap Stun. He chained Compulse. I chained another Trap Stun. Then he chained a third, like the second Wing Blast.
The third. Oh wow.
I was like, must be nice, dude.
Wait. Who was turn player?
He was turn player.
Heels turn player?
Yes, okay.
So he went. Wait, heels turn player and he Wing Blast during his own turn?
Yeah.
Really?
Because I had window already on. So.
I guess.
I made the window, I attack over his stuff, I end my turn, his turn. Like, he already had, like, the three back row, I had the traps, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna get around this.
Interesting.
That was dumb, dude. Both trap stuns, dude!
Yeah, I don't know, man. That's very unfortunate. I was saying if it was your turn, you could have trapped them before you did anything.
Nah. Well, I don't think Bui would have done that reactively. If it was on his turn. But yeah. Red Keys, Prince of Yu-Gi-Oh.
Prince of Yu-Gi-Oh, man.
My turn.
Is that it, Bui?
Yeah, that's it. Unfortunately, I don't think I can stream this Friday. We're one short from the tournament, so it looks like we might have a big prize tournament next Friday. We're like one short. Get one friend to follow.
Get your mom to follow.
So yeah. Thanks for not even Ignister bro for the last follower. Your mom $10 as always. That's it. See you guys.
Wasn't that me? Goodbye.